In essence, what we're really trying to do is work on a new type of nuclear reactor that more or less solves the spent fuel problem. So anybody who's studied nuclear power knows that we don't really know, or at least that's the popular opinion, we don't know what to do with spent fuel. And that's not actually true. We know what to do. We use this new type of nuclear reactor. By using a different kind of coolant, we're actually able to burn that spent fuel and make energy out of it. And more or less what my team is trying to do is help answer the questions of how to build those cooling systems for reactors that solve the spent fuel problem. So current models, you could have fuel that lasts anywhere from thousands of years to tens of thousands of years, and you just have to hold on to it that whole time. And past concepts for how to store it are places like Yucca Mountain. Truthfully, what happens right now, the best answer we have is just store it on site, which presents all sorts of health issues or potential hazards, obviously. Keeping something that dangerous, that close to people for a long time is not a sustainable solution. So with a Generation 4 reactor, we can reduce that time scale down into the decades range. Sodium is not to be mistaken for sodium chloride. That's what table salt is. That's what you put on your food. Sodium itself is actually a metal. It's an element in the periodic table. It's very shiny. It's also very volatile in water. It will release the hydrogen in the water to form hydrogen gas. And since it's an exothermic reaction, it'll actually potentially create a fire. So it's really important, if we're going to use this as a coolant, we really need to make sure that we know for sure it's not going to leak, that we can control it. Liquid sodium is the coolant that we use for one of these types of Generation 4 reactors. And what it lets us do is access a different kind of fission reaction that is a more complete burn-up of the fuel. So we can take spent fuel out of these old reactors that are all around the country. Right now they're just indefinitely storing those fuel pins forever, essentially, at least in terms of human lifetime scales. And we can actually take that fuel and burn it. And so when I arrived here on the faculty, I started THL, and we've since brought in pretty successfully enough funding to start this kind of research on campus.
So what we're interested in doing at Oregon State is taking the lessons learned and the technologies that Billy and company have developed and applying that to the material science issues associated with these nuclear reactors. We brought a team of six folks out here, a mixture of professors, research faculty, postdocs, and students to do knowledge transfer. We're actually hiring on some of Billy's students for grad student positions at Oregon State in this coming year. So,
in education, at least on the academic side of nuclear research, one of our biggest priorities is to make sure we educate the public. We don't need to brainwash them, we don't need to lie to them, we just need to help them understand the data, because the data is really compelling. There's just no statistic that would argue with the fact that it's the safest and cleanest energy on Earth.